Hey guys, welcome back to BOSKY Outdoors. I'm on the road heading back up north to the Bushcraft camp I started a few weeks ago. Had a lot of weather change. I mean, when I was up there 3 weeks ago, I was dealing with about a foot and a half of snow in some places, and close to a foot of snow in the woods itself. And now I'm kind of looking out there. We've had a lot of warm weather and no snow at all, barely any rain. So it's just been melting like crazy. I notice, when I look in the trees, I see some snow on that. So I don't know how it's going to be getting back there. I got a lot of gear to bring back there as I progress on the Bushcraft camp. It's going to be less and less stuff I'm going to bring back there, which is going to be nice, where I can just hopefully just pack a small backpack, and walk back there. But right now I got my pulk sled, and I'm going to try that out. I mean, even if it's grass, I'm still going to be pulling that sled, because it'd be a lot easier than carrying all this heavy stuff with my backpack. So, all right. Well, let's see what it looks like when we get up there, all right? Stay tuned. When I built this trail, there was, there was at least, 8 inches of snow here in the woods. I guess there wasn't a foot. Out in the field, I know there was a lot more, but I cut all these branches to make all these little trees to make this trail, and now there are all these 8-inch sharp deadheads waiting for me to trip and fall on. So I got a little more work to do. I got to cut these down. That way I don't trip, or nobody trips if they come back here. So, a little more work to do. There's some water. I'm glad I did build it up on this little hump here, because there's some water, standing water just down below here. And this is going to be a good day. So I think the truck said 21 degrees out right now. It's Saturday, March 14th. Made it through Friday the 13th. So anyway, let's have some fun. All right. Looks like I got a lot more work to do than I thought. Looking at my shelter here. A lot of the roof braces had fallen down, only because they were sitting on top of 8 inches of snow. Once the snow melted, it pulled them away from the main brace, and they just fell down. Good thing I wasn't laying underneath there when it happened. So, but that's no big deal. I kind of expected some stuff to be falling apart once the snow melts. But now that it's all the way down, I can put them back up, and they're not going to fall until the ground thaws, where I can actually drive some posts into the ground and build it up, the right way I want to do. So, it's kind of cool. It's nice that there isn't any snow around the fire pit and that. I'll clear some of the leaves away in that. But when I was out here last, all that hard packed snow from me walking out all the time turned into basically an ice skating rink. So this time I brought some cleats for my boots, but it doesn't look like I'm gonna need them right now. So that'll be good. Unfortunately, the snow only melted, where the sun hits it, and I figured that's what that was gonna look like. A lot of snow underneath the tarp. So you can see where I had the snow wall built up from the last video. I got my little shovel with. I'll try to shovel out some of the stuff. Try to make it a little more easy to sleep on, but it's a lot of ice. I don't know how well that's going to work out tonight, but I'll figure it out. Maybe I'll throw some more snow in there just to level it out. So let's check out the little creek, see if there's any water moving.
That's kind of cool. Look at this icicles hanging right here. That's cool. Look at a walrus. Oh, anyway. All right, let's check out the creek here.
Oh yeah, it's running pretty good. Oh man, it's beautiful. I won't have to try to melt snow for water because this snow was hard as a rock. You don't sink in at all. I mean, because we had all that thawing, and all of a sudden it's 21 degrees out, and it's just solid. So you're walking on top. I knew I wasn't going to need the snowshoes for something like this, so I left them in the car. This is great. Water's nice and clear. Cool. All right. Bottle of Jägermeister I left here in the snow because a little sip left. It's still here, but it's frozen to the ground. I'm afraid to break the bottle if I try to chip it out of there. So hopefully when I get the fire going and that'll kind of melt a little bit and get her out. That's funny. Some leftover birch bark from last time. That'll be good. We can use that for sure. Safety first. Those ice chips are gonna be flying. Well, that was a lot of work. A lot of cutting, a lot of hauling. I wanted to get a start on collecting all the wood and that for like the sides and the back for building onto the lean-to. It's going to take a lot more than this. A lot of these bigger ones here, I want to use these for the fire deflector. And I figured the live logs will last a lot longer. That's what's nice about being on private property. Landowner, he said, take all these little ones that you want up in this one area because he wants to clear that all out. Hey, no problem. You know, some of it's dead. Be good for firewood and that or for the side. I want to be able to drive the stakes in the ground, but I tried I hit it with my axe once. It was like I hit a rock. You know, I got to sharpen that thing again. But this is a good start. That's a lot of work. That's all I'm going to be cutting this for today on this here.
Getting warm out. It's supposed to get up to about 35 degrees Fahrenheit today. I'll welcome that. I'm better than 21, but you get working, you get sweating.
this is the pile of the brush that I made first time I came out here, when I just kind of cleared out the spot a little bit and the trail, and I kind of threw it all here. And a lot of it's dead, dry dead. So now it's easier to get at, and I just want to try to clean this up a little bit. So I'm making a couple different piles for fire starting, so I can get a fire going a little later on, cook some dinner, and make sure I got enough for in the morning. Because first thing I want to do when I get up in the morning is make a fire and warm up. Last thing I want to do is have to collect firewood in the morning to make a fire to warm up. So, preparation. Oh, that's going to be nice. I think it's a big oak log. Oh man, it's heavy. I pulled it all the way up here in the sled, but just rolling it around and that, it weighs a ton. It seems like it's pretty solid. Talking to the landowner before I came out here, and they had this thing in their yard, and I go, "Hey, can I have that?" "Sure." Score. So I had to go all the way back there with my sled and load her up, bring it back here, and this is going to be great. I mean, if anything for a chair, but splitting wood and just working on crafts, whatever I want to do. All right, this is going to be good. It's starting to look like a camp now. I'm loving it. It's starting to look like a camp. I got my kindling up, my sticks already for the fire. And that's not enough wood. I gotta split some of these, cut and split some of these logs. All right, let's get to it. Thank you.
case you're wondering, I'm making a table. It's going to be nice. Nice height for me to stand here and prepare food and whatnot. And I left this one up high so I can hang something on it. That'll work out great. Now I just got to get a bunch of sticks, put them on there. Eventually I'd like to possibly split a bunch of logs, for make boards or something. Put them across, they're a little flatter, but that would be a lot of work right now. So right now I'm just gonna grab a bunch of sticks, throw them on here, and get a fire going. I'm getting hungry, man. Hungry.
Okay, I made a couple notches on this side. We'll see how this goes. See how that Jägermeister is. Oh, it's unthawed. Got her out. Oh, there's a couple swallows left in there. Whew, this is gonna be good after that day. Oh yeah. I don't know if you noticed when I was putting together the holder for the ribs on my new table, I had brought a couple of boards out with me that I thought I might use for something else, but it worked perfect for that for now. You know, eventually I will get a bunch of sticks in that and put them up there, but right now the boards I'm just going to have to do. Can't have too much barbecue sauce.
I know it's not very bushcrafty, but these boards are really nice. I don't know, man. I'll have to make a cutting board. Moment of truth. Oh, yeah. It's a bit woody. Look at that. Perfectly done. Oh my gosh. Hot bread. I'm gonna eat good today. Moment of truth. Oh man, those are the best ribs I've had all day. I've said it before, things just taste so much better when you're cooking over an open fire. I don't know if it's because you work your ass all day and you just appreciate it more, but I don't know, this is really good. Cheers. Wow, that was a great day. Oh man, what a great dinner. Barbecue ribs, mushrooms, yellow peppers, and a nice little loaf of bread. That's awesome. You know what it is? And you know what time it is. It's dessert time. Darn right. And it is Isla del Sol. I believe it's by Tabac. Gotta get a little flame on there, I think. Very nice. Well, good morning. I slept really well last night. Not a coyote sound at all. So that was pretty good. Oh man. This thing's working out really well. My little blanket here. That's what I use instead of getting underneath the sleeping bag. I can just pull that over my head. Nice and light, it holds in the heat but not too much. You don't feel smothered, you know, under a big sleeping bag. That works great. And I don't have a bivy for my sleeping bag, and this helps keep some of the dew off of the bag. So the other thing I learned last time I was out here was my boots, they get wet. You know, yeah, they're waterproof. My feet didn't get wet inside, but they're leather boots, and they get wet, and then they're frozen in the morning. And that's all I had out here was those. So I grabbed these this time because I knew it was going to be wet back here. These are Browning 2,000 gram Thinsulate rubber boots, waterproof. And those really worked out well, but I knew in the morning I can't lay down and put on my boots. I just can't do it. My back and everything. So I brought my cheap slippers, a rubber bottom. I throw those on. I can walk around camp. These are great to have. They're light. All night I just kind of kept them tucked under my sleeping bag so they didn't get cold or anything. So this has been great. You know, when I get a fire going, I can set my boots next to the fire and maybe warm them up a little bit, but right now my feet are fine. So, yep. I think I will get a fire going. I don't have coffee today, but I do have some chaga. I'm going to make that and get a little breakfast going and decide what I want to do the rest of the day. All right.
This is called chaga or chaga, depends on where you're from. It's a growth that grows on the side of birch trees. And when you get nice and gold like that, makes an excellent tea, almost like a sweet coffee. Very good. Well, here's a stick that I cooked the ribs on last night. I left it laying on the ground, and the water got at it, and it was froze to the ground. Anyway, I got my little grill grade here. It's actually a really tiny grill grade that came inside an old toaster oven. This thing's been perfect. You know, it's just tiny and... Let's see how this will work. Yeah. Perfect.
Well, it's that time of day. Got to call her quits and load everything up, head back to the car. Well, looks like I'm all packed up, ready to go. If you like the video, press like, hit that notification bell, and you get a notification every time I put out a new video. And share them with your friends. They might enjoy them too. All right, you guys keep warm, keep healthy, and see you next time on the trail. Take care.